Hello, good day students. You are welcome to physics class once more. Today we want to have a look at applications of lenses. Under that, we want to pay attention to three important points. We want to have a brief review on lenses, because this is just the application. The main lesson on lens have been taken already. After that, we look at simple camera and projector, then finally microscope and telescope. What are lenses? What is a lens? A lens is an object that is usually made of glass or clear transparent plastics. Either a glass or a transparent clear plastic that defocuses the light that passes through it. Is a clear example. You can see rays of light by your left incidenting on this particular convex lens. And the convex lens will make the light ray to converge at a point. This is focusing the rays of light incidenting on the lens. In this other case, you can see that the rays of light by your left coming incidenting on this particular lens. After incidenting on it, it will spread out. Unlike the first one, that the thing will converge here. In this other one, the rays of light will diverge out. So that is defocusing, that is what diverging it. In this case, we have focusing, that is what converging the rays of light. That's what a lens is all about. Let me repeat myself once more. A lens is an object usually made of glass or transparent plastic that focuses, meaning that converges, or defocuses, that means that diverges the light that passes through it. We have basically two types of lenses, the convex and the concave lens. The convex lens is, in other words, known as converging lens. You can see it here, convex or converging lens. Number two is concave or diverging lens. So let's pick each one separately and talk on it. Let's have a look at a convex lens. Convex lens, that's the number one, makes a parallel beam of light to converge at a point as it passes through it. This is a typical example of that. This is a typical example. As the rays of light pass through the lens makes the rays of light to converge at a point. This type of lens is called a convex lens, in other words, a converging lens. Why do we call it a converging lens? Because it converges. It focuses the incidenting rays of light on it to meet at a particular point, that very focal point. Type of lens. The second type of lens is concave lens. A concave lens is a diverging lens. It makes a parallel beam of light diverge as it passes through the lens. You can see by your left we have incidenting parallel rays of light, but as it passes through the concave lens, the rays of light got diverged out. They spread out through. They didn't meet at a point. This is the comparison between the two. You can see the first one, which is the convex lens, converges the rays of light. In the case of the second one, it diverges. The same thing we have in the second picture. Then, in this very particular table, we have a distinction between the convex, which is the converging, and the concave, which is divergent lenses. The first difference between the two is that a convex lens is thicker in the middle than at the edges. That's for convex lens. You can see it here by your left. You can see it's thicker at the middle than at the edges. While in the other case, a concave lens is thinner in the middle than at the edges. That's the one you're having by your right here. So the second distinction is that for convex lens, it is a converging lens. See it by the left here. It converges rays of light. While in the other case of convex lens, it is a diverging lens. See it by the right. It diverges the rays of light to spread out through. The third one is that a convex lens produces mostly real images. Mostly convex lenses, the converging lenses produces what? It do produce a real image, While in the case of concave lens, that is the diverging one, do produce a virtual image in most cases. Then the final distinction between the two, in my own case here, is that the convex lens is being used to treat hypermetropia, while we use the divergent lens, which is the concave lens, to treat a myopia. These are some sight defects that can be learned better maybe when we get to sight defect and correction. Next you want to look at is camera. What is a camera? A camera is an optical instrument used to record visual images in form of photographs. As we have a digital one, you can see in the picture. To record photograph, film, or video signals. That is what a camera does. But at their most basic, at the fundamental, cameras are sealed boxes. They are light proof. They don't allow light out of the box. And they don't allow light from other angles to penetrate into the box. They are light proof boxes with a small hole that allow light in order that allow light into the box. What is the essence of that? To capture an image on a light sensitive surface, that's on the screen. Cameras have various mechanisms to control how light fall onto the light sensitive surface. This is a typical example of a camera. But what you want to look at today as we are dealing with application of lenses is simple lens cameras, so that we see the application of lenses in producing images. Simple lens camera has a fixed distance between the lens and the film, which is equal to the focal length of the lens. That means the distance between the film and the converging lens must equal to the what? Must equal to the focal length of the particular lens in consideration. Some cameras have bellows or focusing rings for adjusting the distance between the lens and the film so that objects in front of the lens can always be sharp and focused. Projector now. What's a projector? This is a simple lens camera. You can see it here. A simple lens camera having bellows there that are used, or a focusing node at the down here that is being used to adjust the distance between the converging lenses and the film. Now the projector. Projector equally portrays the application of lenses. A projector is an optical instrument for projecting on a screen and a large image of a transparent object. This is an example of a slide projector, fundamental one. You can see one here. This is one. See, it's combination of lenses. Though we have mirror at the extreme left here, concave mirror that will center and direct the light that fall on it back to the condenser lens, and it will send the light down to the slide or to the film. Then at a point, it meets at the optical center of the projection lens. Then finally at the screen on your extreme right hand side. See another picture of it here too. Optical system of a projector. See another one here. So if you observe in this particular case, see the object is small. That is what you have there at the lamp after the mirror. But see how it has been enlarged to appear on the screen. The same thing here, to be enlarged, to be seen bigger on the screen. That is what a projector does. Okay, now the essential component of a slide projector. This very particular projector is called a slide projector. Either this or this or this. What are the essential components of these projectors? Number one, we have a small but powerful light source. You can see here we have a lamp. This is the light source. In this case too, we have another one here. You can see it here, it's lamp. You equally have another one here, light source at this particular C. So that's one of the component of a slide projector. What is the essence of that small but powerful light source? Is to illuminate the object, which is usually non-luminous. The object is non-luminous, that means it cannot generate and emit light on its own. So we need a light source that will assist in illuminating
the objects. A converging mirror placed behind the light source. We used to keep a converging mirror. See, by your left, behind the lamp, we have a concave mirror, which is a converging mirror. It's kept by that particular side. What is the essence of keeping such a converging mirror? We do keep it there so it will help to direct the light onto the film or screen or the slide. The second important component in slide projector is the condenser. The condenser consisting of two plano convex lenses. You see it here. You have the condenser lens. You can see there are two plano convex mirrors. We have them two there. That's the condenser. Consists of two plano convex lenses that collect the light from the light source. You can see these two lenses collect light from the lamp. They collect the light from what? From the light source and concentrate it on the slide. You can see behind the condenser down here, next you have is a slide or a film. It will collect the light from the light source and direct the light on the slide or on the screen. That's what it does, and illuminates every part of it strongly and evenly. It distributes the light evenly as required. Number three is the slide carrier. We have a slide here. This particular slide between the condenser lens and projection lens, we have a slide. The slide is not just standing on its own there. Rather, there is what you call a slide carrier. It's the one carrying the slide. It's a frame in which the slide is placed upside down. Why do we put the slide upside down? So that it appear erect on the screen. The image should appear erect on the screen. This is the screen, the one you have at the extreme end here, where you should be able to get the picture. Number four is what you call projection lens. You can see it here. This is your projection lens. Projection lens is one of the essential components of our slide projector. This particular one is placed near the slide. It produces a large and inverted image of the slide, and it focuses it on the screen. So it is one that finally focuses the image on the screen. Then finally, we have the screen itself. The screen is this very particular thing you are seeing. This is your screen where the image will be captured, where the image will be what will be formed. Usually white. In most cases, screen used to be white. It receives the image which is right way up. If the object is inserted upside down, it will invert it into the slide carrier. The principle of slide projector is used in scene projector, photographic enlargers, and several other optical devices. That's all for application of lenses. We still have more two things to look at. That is the microscope and telescope. We'll be looking at that one in the next class. See you next class. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.